Suppose the demand for a product is given by D of P equals negative 7P plus 144. For part A, calculate the elasticity of demand at a price of $12. B, at what price do we have unit elasticity? The elasticity of demand function is often given in one of two forms shown below, where first we have E of P equals the opposite of P times D prime of P divided by D of P. The elasticity of demand is always non-negative, which is the reason why we have this negative sign here. Because the demand function is a decreasing function, D prime of P is negative, and taking the opposite of a negative will make this function non-negative. Another way to express E of P is E of P equals the absolute value of P times D prime of P divided by D of P, where the absolute value makes E of P non-negative. Notice to find D of P, we must first find D prime of P. D prime of P is equal to the derivative of negative 7P plus 144, which is equal to negative 7. And now we can find E of P, and let's use this first formula here. E of P is equal to the opposite of P times D prime of P, which is negative 7, divided by D of P. Let's write D of P as 144 minus 7P. Simplifying, notice how we have the opposite of P times negative 7, which is positive 7P. E of P is equal to 7P divided by the quantity 144 minus 7P. And now we can determine the elasticity of demand at a price of $12, which is E of 12. E of 12 equals 7 times 12 divided by the quantity 144 minus 7 times 12. 7 times 12 equals 84. This is equal to 84 divided by the quantity 144 minus 84, which equals 84 divided by 60, which equals 1.4. The elasticity is 1.4 at a price of $12. Let's review what this tells us. Because elasticity is equal to 1.4, the total revenue is decreasing because E is greater than 1, demand is elastic, an increase in price will bring a decrease in revenue. And now for the second part of this question, we're asked at what price do we have unit elasticity? This refers to the situation where the total revenue is maximized at the values of P for which E, the elasticity, equals 1. And we say demand is unit elastic, or we have unit elasticity. So to answer part B, we need to set E of P equal to 1 and solve for P. Let's do this on the next slide. E of P equals 7P divided by the quantity 144 minus 7P, and we set this equal to 1 and solve for P to determine the price at which we have unit elasticity. We could write 1 as a fraction with the denominator of 1 and then cross multiply, but let's clear the fraction from the left side of the equation by multiplying both sides of the equation by the denominator of 144 minus 7P. Notice on the left side is a fraction, we would have a denominator of 1 here, and these factors simplify to 1, which gives us the equation 7P equals 144 minus 7P. Add 7P to both sides of the equation. Simplifying, we have 14P equals, this simplifies to 0, we have 14P equals 144. Solve for P, we divide both sides by 14. Simplifying, 14 divided by 14 is 1. 1 times P is P. The price is equal to 144 divided by 14. Run into the nearest penny is approximately $10.29. So at this price, the total revenue is maximized. I hope you found this helpful.